Morning, guys. Happy New Year. This is my first video in January of 2015. But anyways, I had a little quick thought, and I know I'm going to say this. Oh, and by the way, I hope you guys like the new facial hair. Me and Ivan have started our shaved head and face for 4 months, and we'll see who's got who grows the most hair in January, February, March. April 2nd is the final day. So no shaving, no nothing. We just clean slate, and April 2nd, whoever's got the most hair wins. And I don't think we're really doing anything, like we'd get something out of the other person, but whatever, maybe we'll figure something out. I don't know. But no, so today I wanted to make this video because I saw this video today, and it's a funny video. It's this guy, he's writing his final alimony check to his ex-wife. And, you know, like, I'm not one to judge these guys or anything like that. Like, maybe, you know, he could have been an asshole. Maybe he cheated on her and he had to write these alimony checks, whatever. But he tells you how much the check is, and it's over 10 grand. So he's been writing 10 grand a month for however many years to his ex-wife. And I'm assuming they live in California. And California has this law that it's a no-fault state. So whoever gets divorced, you know, doesn't matter who did what to who. It's just you get divorced, and this person, like, your wife, and it goes both ways, but I know women are going to be upset about what I'm going to say. You know, it goes both ways. And if the man and woman get divorced and one of them was used to a certain lifestyle, the judge orders that their ex-spouse now has to pay them X amount of dollars so that way they can keep up that lifestyle for a certain amount of time until they can get their own job and stuff like that. So, example, like if it was a stay-at-home mom and this lady was used to her husband giving her 10 grand a month to spend and they got divorced, well, she still needs her 10 grand a month because she doesn't have a job because she was stuck at home taking care of this guy's kids. And to me, it's kind of fucked up because 10 grand a month is an insane amount of money. Like, I would marry someone to divorce them in California just to get 10 grand a month. That is insane to me. Like, why is it that high? It shouldn't be that high. Here in California, we need to renegotiate this alimony shit because this shit is not flying. Sorry, that was a hair in my face. But, like, to me, what's wrong with her? Like, she can't get a job? Like, go do a job so your fucking ex-husband doesn't have to pay you alimony. To me, alimony shouldn't even be paid unless, like, the guy was abusive or, you know, he was a complete fucking asshole. Just because you didn't get divorced doesn't mean you should get alimony, which blows my fucking mind. But then I thought about this, and this is a good analogy, and hopefully the women who are shouting at me going, oh my God, Eddie, if a man did something to a woman and he gets divorced with her, then she should get money. It's a punishment for him, or whatever, however you want to consider it, right? Whatever you're saying. Consider it this. Just consider it this way. If I was working at a job and I was making $100,000 a year or whatever you want to call it, right? And for whatever reason, I lose my job. My job fires me. My job lays me off. Can I sue my job because I'm used to the lifestyle that job provided me and get money a month from that job until I find a new job? No. Unemployment does, but unemployment's half of what I was making. Like, that shit, and unemployment doesn't even last like a year. I think it's 6 months or some shit like that. And then you have to renew to try to get it extended. So it's complete horseshit to me, because if I had a good job, I can't sue them to get the money that job provided my lifestyle. And it should be the same way. A woman shouldn't, and a man shouldn't, get alimony. If the man divorces the woman and she was the financial breadwinner, then he shouldn't get alimony from her. If the woman divorces a man and he was the financial breadwinner, then she shouldn't get money from him. It just go your separate ways. When shit doesn't work out, it's because it didn't fucking work out. Your lifestyle, he's not living the same lifestyle. She's not living the same lifestyle. You're both not living the same lifestyle you were when you were together. I know somebody's going to be like, oh, Eddie, you don't understand. No, I do understand. You're taking money from a man because he divorced you. And you're trying to stick it to him. And if you say you're not, you're a fucking liar. I would say this to your face. Whoever came up to me and said that shit, well, no, it's because, you know, I need help getting on my feet. No, you're a fucking liar because you could go get a job and you could stop taking his fucking money. That's bullshit. You're trying to stick it to him because he got a divorce from you. And like I said, I would say it to both people. If a man was getting alimony, I would say the same shit to him, but I'm confronting the women because I know the women are going to be the maddest about what I'm saying right now. Anyways, I hope you guys had a good New Year's, and I'll see you later. You know, it's a fresh, brand new year. You know, time to step in the right direction. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying.